ですが、時間がかかります。
You're my good luck charm now, girl.
Yeah, I'm lucky girl.
Yeah.
You got this kimono dressing to me. Gentlemen, today we are proud to introduce you the national costume of Japan called kimono. We will give you a demonstration of how kimono is dressed and explain some things about kimono. Let me explain to you some characteristics of Japanese kimono. As you can see, the kimono looks like a T-shaped gown. Can you see? But once it is dressed, it is a beautiful full-length dress. One of the main characteristics of the kimono is that it is made with only straight lines. Kimono is made from a single bolt of fabric called han. Bolts come in standard dimensions of about 14 inches wide and 12.5 yards, and the entire fabric is used to make one piece of kimono for an adult. The finished kimono consists of four main strips of fabric, two panels covering the body, and two panels forming the sleeves, with additional smaller strips forming a narrow front panel and collar. So the textile is only cut into a minimum number of parts. Also, even if it is for a very short person, the fabric is not cut and wasted. This makes the kimono easy to be retailored or recycled. Because most formal kimono are made of silk, the kimono has traditionally been hand washed by taking all the parts apart, stretched to dry on special wooden stretchers, and resewn by hand. The washed, stretched, dried, and resewn kimono are like brand new, and it can be retailored to fit a different person. For example, the kimono Hiroko is wearing today was handed down from her grandmother to her mother, and now to Hiroko. Kimono may be quite expensive, but if taken proper care, it can be worn by several generations. Mai is already dressed in her undergarment today. These kimono-shaped robes are worn beneath the main outer garment. This is made of silk as well. Only the color edge of this robe shows from beneath the outer kimono. The color is removable, allowing us to change the piece of silk to match the outer garment, and to be easily washed without washing the entire garment. Underneath this robe, Mai is also wearing thin garment made of cotton and petticoat-like garment. Since silk kimono are delicate and difficult to clean, this helps to keep the outer kimono clean by preventing contact with the wearer's skin. And Japan can be very hot and humid during the summer season, so you can imagine how much it helps. Now, Hiroko will start dressing Mai. As you can see, the kimono is very long. The lengths of the kimono are not hemmed to fit the person. Rather, it is made to fold it at the waist to fit it to ankle length. On a rainy day, we could decide to wear the kimono a little bit shorter. There are no buttons or zippers in kimono. Different kind of coats and sashes are tied around the body to wear kimono. Today, in order for Hiroko to dress Mai with her kimono, she will be using 7 kinds of sashes or belts. One thing that is good to remember if you want to wear a kimono yourself, kimono are always worn with the left side over the right. We only dress the dead for burial with the right over left. In case you forget, if you take your right hand to your collar, you can stick your right hand like a pocket. Many modern Japanese women lack the skill to put on a kimono by herself. The typical woman's kimono consists of 12 or more separate pieces that are worn, matched, and secured in the prescribed ways, and the assistance of professional kimono dressers are often required. Hiroko learned how to dress kimono by going to classes for a year and several months of apprenticeship. These classes also cover many rules of kimono, such as selecting seasonally and event-appropriate patterns and fabrics, matching the kimono to appropriate sashes and other accessories, as well as dressing men and children. Even though kimono is still the most popular formal outfit on special occasions, many women are not wearing kimono as they used to because of the many hurdles to wear a kimono. Maybe you have noticed that the length of my sleeves is much longer than Hiroko's. Now, I will explain a little about some ranks of formality in kimono. Kimono range from extremely formal to casual. The level of formality of women's kimono is determined mostly by the pattern, fabric, and color. Mai's kimono is the most formal kimono for young women. These full-length sleeve kimono signify a married status and tend to be more elaborate. Many young women wear this kind of kimono to celebrate their adulthood at 20 years of age. Mai is not yet 20 years old, but this kimono was a gift from her grandmother, and this was originally worn by her aunt before she got married. Also, Mai's kimono has one big pattern throughout the kimono, meaning a very formal kimono. On the other hand, kimono Hiroko is wearing today has repeated patterns, which has a less formal status. Hiroko cannot wear this kimono to a formal function such as a wedding. きます。Kimono can be made from different kind of fabric. Silk is the most desirable and most formal. You can get kimono made of wool, cotton, and in recent years, polyester kimono can be purchased at a more reasonable price. They are very convenient as it is often hand washed, but of course they are not comparable to silk kimono in their beauty. Kimono can be expensive. Many of you might wonder how much. Well, women's silk kimono may easily exceed $3,000. A complete kimono outfit with kimono, undergarments, obi, ties, socks, sandals, and accessories can exceed $5,000. And that is the beginning. If you think about the months spending by professionals hand dyeing, drawing, embroidering, sewing a piece of kimono, you can easily imagine that a good piece of kimono can cost more than that. Also, depending on the craftsmanship, a single sash may cost several thousand dollars. But there is good news for those of you who want to purchase one yourself. Recently, you can get used kimono at great prices. As I said earlier, many women are not wearing their kimono anymore, and expensive kimono that are most brand new are on the used market for cheap price. It is a pity that we are moving away from this beautiful traditional costume. Now, Hiroko is putting on a thin fabric covered board to place under the sash called obi. The sash is also made of silk with an elaborate silk embroidery. The board will help the sash keep its shape. Today, Hiroko will be tying the sash like a butterfly that will match the spring season. Well, today is not very, very spring, but it's supposed to be. And I will be using a long formal sash today that goes with the formal kimono. There are literally hundreds of designs for tying the sash. The way sash is tied also signifies formality, women's marital status, and occasion. Last stage that she's putting. You will see the butterfly. While you are waiting, I'd like to show a kind of kimono, which is called yukata. Okay, this is a summer kind of kimono, which is very, very casual. Not this one, but the thinner fabric of yukata can be worn when you are sleeping. Like if you visit a traditional Japanese hotel, they provide you to wear this kind of, but more casual, thin, soft clothes. So you will enjoy your yukata there. And this is much cheaper. Of course. The last piece of cord is now being tied. This is actually the main cord that is holding the whole sash. Now, finally, Mai will put her footwear called zori to complete her outfit. Thank you for your being patient, and we hope you enjoy the show.